From the very beginning, we've been breaking rules. The number one rule of community development is you don't move people. The number one thing we decided to do is we got to get them out of there because it's toxic, it's killing people. And so we started out with 10 families because you can handle that many. It's not too big, it's not too small. And if you start with 10 families, you're talking about 60 to 70 kids that you will affect in the second generation. So you start pretty small, but the impact you're having for the future is pretty large. So we start with two questions, and what kind of person do you want to be, and what kind of community do you want to live in? The idea is at the end of this 5 years, that they can live independently. They get the house that they built, and they get about a manzana of land. We have vocational education for the parents as well as regular education. It's mandatory that all the adults here learn to read and write. They have the option of going and finishing secondary school or even continuing on to college if they want to. We teach them how to do agriculture, how to grow both traditional crops, which are the crops that they eat, and the non-traditional crops. We teach the women how to make things for the tourist market. The women also learned about construction. All of the women that live here know how to build a building. But the children, which is really the target audience of this project, have the advantage of living in this community, going to this school, and learning the things that we're teaching until they're 18. So we have a private school for the kids. We go to school 6.5 hours a day instead of 3.5. We have 8 subjects that in regular Nicaraguan schools don't study, everything from Christian education, computers, English, art, music, drama, and dance. But one of the things we've done is work with the teachers so that they use a more interactive style of teaching, and the kids participate more, and the kids love it. These kids are all learning to be readers. And the goal for our teachers is not to teach X amount of math or X amount of Spanish, but to give the children a love for learning. There's nobody doing what we're doing. We're transforming people. We're not just giving houses. We're not just giving food. We're not just giving education. We're putting it all together and saying if somebody is going to participate in the society, we're giving them all the things that they need so that they can be part of that society.